Hello and welcome to Two and Door Gaming, and we're going to play a lovely game I called I Don't Remember What I Was Saying Back Then. I had some, I had some recording problems, and so, when I went to edit, there was no sound, so now we've got to try and work out what I was doing and do a little narration track. I know that I wanted to put together the backpack and show you how that worked, so here, I believe that's what I'm doing. Yes, you need a chest. You need 4 wool. And 4 leather, and you arrange it like so, and you get your basic backpack. And when you get some iron, and then gold, and then diamond, you can upgrade it and make it a lot bigger than that. But that's still pretty helpful little boost there. So, yeah, no sound. That happens every now and again. My equipment fails on me, and I don't find out until I go to edit. Even though I try and test before I do every video. So yeah, I'm just showing you put the iron around it, put another chest above it, and you can upgrade to the next level iron. So I've got a whole bunch of, bricks. I'm going to sell a lot of bricks. I've gone and plundered the little structure that was over there, just grabbed some stuff, and I noticed that the Millionaire Village liked those bricks, so I wanted to sell them to them and get a boost and show that little economy effect. They won't take the stairs or the slabs though, just the basic bricks. They'll take clay, a brick by itself, or the combination of bricks. So, and that all goes in nicely. So, I told you when I looked at it, I didn't know if there was a chest or anything under it or whatever. So, I just went and used the ore excavator. Ripped up a bunch of bricks, and lo and behold, what did I find but a spawner, and also a chest under there. So yeah, I'm about to show you that bit. See, there we are. So not a place to linger at night, obviously, but not too difficult. Just a single spawner as far as I could find, and a single chest. What am I doing? I guess I'm just gas bagging. I waffle on a bit, don't I? Okay. So what I wanted to do, oh yes, the chest transporter. The great thing about chest transporters is they also work for spawners. So I can pick up this spawner here rather than destroy it. And later on I can create myself a mob farm, an experience farm. Pretty handy stuff. So, but you'll notice when you use a chest transporter, there's quite the penalties. But now that I have a backpack, there's a little sneaky workaround. If I put the chest transporter in there and wait a second, boom, all the negative effects are gone. So that is a very helpful tip if you want to pick up a spawner for your XP farm, or just pick up a chest. Then it's designed to be super heavy, but the magic of a backpack, will take away the weight for you, and you'll be fine. Nice work, huh? Heh heh, tricky, tricky. So, what's in it? Not the most exciting haul, that's for sure. So, I don't know if that's standard. Some of these structures seem to have a standard amount in it. Like, if you find one of those little graves. Is it a grave? And you dig into it, you'll find just a double chest with a bunch of bones. Hey, and I think a skeleton skull. So assume that's to represent there what used to be a body in that coffin. So this is the first time I've plundered one of these things, so I have no idea whether there is more to find in it. But you get that. So while I'm here, I may as well pick up a heap more bricks, sell them all up. At the moment, I've only got 9 teeny tiny little denier. Nothing to write home about, and we want more than that, don't we? Yes, we do! Because if we're going to get our reputation up to start our own Millionaire Village, then we are going to need more stuff. So, but I won't bore you with all of that. That's how I tend to work. I come back later and finish the job. Now, those blue lines, thank you very much. Got 2 answers. One from Rowan, one from Seraphim. And they both told me that those blue lines designate the boundary of the Techtopia villages. So, as far out as they will go. So, that is handy to know. And maybe there's a way to turn it off, I'm not sure, but now at least I know what they're for. So if you see those as well, that's it. If you see those and you didn't realize there was a village nearby, well, it's time to search around, because there is. So thank you very much for that information. So I'm going to go head over to Millionaire. Another thing Seraphim said that I thought was a really good summary is when you, which village, I guess, to pursue. Because, as I've said earlier, there's three different types that you can create. Millionaire, Techtopia, and Mine Colonies. But I'll just run through this and then I'll read you out what she sent me. So yes, I'm going to sell up all of those bricks, take them all. They don't seem to have a limit generally on what they'll, how much of something they'll buy. They do tend to have a limit on how much they can sell you. It actually is dictated by what they have in stock. And if you want them to have something in stock, you can help encourage them to give them the right materials to make stuff for you. I definitely want to get that pouch, and bingo, I've sold enough bricks that I now have it, and all my money goes into there. Saves me having up to three piles, like when you get a gold one, can't remember what it's called. Anyway, you've got those three different coins now, it all goes into a simple pouch. Just remember to bring it to you when you go shopping, because you won't automatically go in there when you add something to your inventory. So now I'm looking for the boss of the village. That's not the boss of the village. No, that's not him. Keep moving. To see my when my things change. I can't remember if I actually did find them or not. Oh yeah, there they are. So now my favorite trader. Woohoo! And I can buy a plot. The first one's a plot. Second one is a little house. And when I say little house, it's a little house. Unless you want just a little house for storing a couple of things, wait till you can afford more stuff. And that, of course, comes down to selling, buying, doing little quests, improving your reputation with the particular village. Now, diplomatic points, but there's no other villages to poison or praise. So now it's time to go to the Techtopia. Now, let me quickly read what Sarah said. Said, if you're a player builder who likes to build their own structures, Techtopia may be for you. If you're not a builder but want to be involved in city planning and place certain structures in certain locations, then Mine Colonies is for you. If you want to do quests but don't really want to deal with the whole village situation, you can buy plots of land or have millionaire villagers build you a home where you will achieve friend of the village status through trading and or completing millionaire quests. Eventually, you may be able to find a suitable location, become the ruler of your very own millionaire village. So yeah, and I thought that's a really good sum up. If you like to build your own houses, Techtopia is the key, because you build the house, then you whack the little item frame and stuff on top. At the doorway, not on top. At the doorway, designated as a particular kind of building, and you can get the right villagers in there and whatnot. But you build everything, and yeah, they won't actually rebuild or build anything. They don't do structures. They do a bunch of other stuff, but they don't do structures. So you have to do all of that. And if you enjoy building, then Techtopia is definitely something to get into fast. If you're not a builder, or you don't like the repetition of it, then Mine Colonies certainly, because you can still plan where buildings go, but you have a builder there who does the work for you. And all of the structures are pre-designed, and you just choose which one you want, what kind of look you want, and you put that in. Here I am, mind you, the video you're looking at now is me starting to pull apart this Techtopia village. Because with the millionaire crossing over it, they're going to probably build over the top, and the village is just going to fall apart a little, especially considering the storehouses are within the zone. So I figure, yep, this is the one I'm going to pull apart and steal all their materials to make my own. And they don't mind. They just walk around looking at what they look at, I guess. Which is cool. Anyway, so yeah, so Mine Colonies, if you like to plan it but not build it, you prefer to do other stuff, and then there's Millionaire, if you just want a base, basically, you you can just get that house, build up your reputation, get them to build your house, and have your base in there, and not have to worry about anything. And go and do your other stuff, your quest lines, or whatever, getting to the end and killing the dragon, or whatever it is that keeps you interested in Minecraft. That's what I really do like about Life in the Village, is you've got different pathways you can take, depending on what kind of player you are. Whether you just like the sandbox stuff and the building, then definitely Techtopia adds an extra development, an extra element to your building, because you've got a purpose. You're trying to structure a functional village and help it grow and be successful and defend and whatever you, right? So that's a great thing if you like that element, sandbox building element. If you're just about the adventure and chopping up mobs, then yeah, you can have a base. You don't even have to, you can put down your starter home and just do that and go for the roguelike dungeons. See if you can get to the bottom and beat the real bad bosses, get some serious equipment, and then take on the nether in the end or whatever. You've got that option. If you are a quest completer, I tend to be a little bit like that. I like getting all the quests done. Then it's got a great quest book and flow through for you. So you can, that sense of completion, and doing bits of everything. Or whatever. I mean, Mine Colonies adds that extra element of a purpose. Sometimes I think the trouble people have had with Minecraft in the past is like, why do you play it? What am I playing for? And Mine Colony gives you that aspect of trying to level up all your buildings, keep your people safe, have a functional, viable village, but without the building element that Techtopia puts in. So here I am. There's a lot of stuff to plunder here, so I am getting my chest transporters ready so I can pick up all the stuff that I've plundered. Oh, now check out this guy. I was not ready. And this is bad news for me because I wasn't even holding a weapon. I was too busy fooling around with my chest, and I got ambushed by a spider-riding skeleton. Yeah, and I died. Now, it wasn't my intention, but this is a cool thing in that I can show you how the graves work. Right, I got my death inventory list, and that just keeps a record of everything I had on me when I died, but also where it was. It's numbered, it's sort of where it was in my inventory. So when I get it back, it can not only give me back my stuff, but put it back where I was holding it, which is very helpful. You don't have to worry about all your stuff disappearing because it's sitting on the ground, or some random zombie picking up your pretty helmet and running off with it, because it's all in the grave site. And you got that lovely little smoke trail to lead you back to your death zone. So I slept through the night so I wouldn't have to worry so much about mobs and sort of protecting myself when I get back there. So this is one of those happy, unhappy circumstances where I certainly don't mean to die. But it does help me show you how things work. Oh yeah, these cinder blooms. I just wanted to point those out. Those will set you on fire. Be very careful of those. And remember, if you try and break it directly, it will set you on fire. Because it's a Dungeon Tactics flower, its effect affects you when you touch it. So dig under it. Remove the block it's sitting on, and you safely unplant it. Or, yeah. Weed it, I guess, might be a way to look at it. Okay, so we're coming back, just making sure the dude on the spider's not there. Nope. Look, mystery meat. Guess what the mystery meat is, folks? Tasty. Cook that up later. So, there is my, my gravestone. So, I just have to, you just stand on it, and then shift, you know, crouch. And you'll get your stuff and back in the right spots. And it will move items around if you've accumulated a few extra things along the way. So not too difficult. Now I've got a beacon there forever that tells me where I died, but you can get rid of that. You press your J button, get your map up, go to waypoints, and you can turn it off. And it will remain there, just not visible, or you can remove like I did, because I don't need it anymore. I got my stuff back. So that was an interesting little side diversion in this particular episode. So what did I do next? I still got to pick up the chest. Am I going to do that? Oh, yeah. So this is a good thing in a recent update. For a while there, the levels you spent would disappear when you died, and you'd have to accumulate them all again, which was really tough, because like when you're doing that treasure hunting, you put a lot of levels into that, and have to go back to square one with it was really it made you a lot less enthusiastic about the level up options. But now it does retain it, so that's good. So you spend your levels when you get them, and you're death-proof losing it, basically, which is very handy now. I'm very happy that Dreams sort of reversed that aspect of the mod pack. Okay, now it's just inventory management. Ah, oh, the joys of inventory management. Okay, once again. With this trick, with the chest transporter, you can get a lot of stuff. And I mean a lot of stuff in that pack, which is really cool. And I tell you what, I take out this whole village. The lot, mate. Let's skip ahead. Ding! This is all that's left. We've got a farm plot, because, I mean, I don't need to pick that up. May as well leave it there growing, doing its thing. Everything else, you look in the background, it's all gone, except for two other things. Well, there's the path. I accidentally took out the well. It wasn't my intention, but oh well. but I've left two things apart from the farm behind. There's the waystone. This is removable. You notice when you look at it, it comes up, harvestable pickaxe. You can move it and put it wherever you want yourself, but the bounty board is not harvestable. You can certainly break it, but you can't move it. So if you want to fill that bounty quest, you're going to need this. But have a look at some of this stuff. One gold ingot. I've got to kill 6 skeletons in a certain amount of time to get 1 gold ingot. 34 wheat, and I get 1 gold ingot and some nuggets. This is what I don't like about this. It's really not a good deal. I really don't feel like it's a good deal. But, you know, get a quest and then ignore it. It's sort of how I feel about it. Just tick it off. Move along. You can have the stuff. Yeah. Some of these are just 6 bread for 3 gold nuggets. Yeah. 17 sugar, 10 spider eyes. Nah. Psst. That's what I say. Like that guy. Psst. No thank you. So I'm going to leave the bounty board here and fill it in when I get there, I guess. I get the idea behind it. There we go. Quest completed. Woohoo. Done. But it needs better rewards. To really be something viable, to be something interesting, it needs better rewards. And I can't even get this. I remember this particular quest, I couldn't even get it to sort of go, okay, here's a sign. Now, give me my prize or something. I think I need to put the signs in there, but I can't work it out. Nope, it won't take it. It's just like, well, now what? Eh. I'll look it up later. Like, I have not found it particularly useful, so I've not actually pursued it. I should, for the sake of rounding out the videos, look it up properly, so that I can tell you. I should have done that before now. Whoops. Sorry. I'll get onto that. Honest. Yeah, but I'm definitely going to take the waystone, and then I can put it wherever I want it. At the moment, I've got the other waystone in the other village, which is close to my home, so it's not much of a, like, I don't really need to put it next to my little starter base. I'm probably going to save it until I get my forever home village, and then I can have that link between this area and that. Yeah, even if I pull apart the other Tectopia village, I'll leave the waystone there, and that can be close enough, I figure. And save me a bit of time. Okay, well, thanks for watching this episode. Next time, I'll have some proper audio for you.